That was Foo Fighters with Learn to Fly as they make their way over to the couch. The band's name derived from a little-known fact that you may not know about, which is, of course, the Allied planes experienced a little-known phenomenon, which was fiery balls over the German skies during World War II. Now, these were believed to be a newly developed German weapon known as the Foo Fighters. Foo, of course, being slang for the French word for fire, feu. To tell us more about it, please welcome from the Foo Fighters, David, Taylor, and Christopher.
Right. Welcome. Thank you very much for opening our show.
Welcome.
Brilliant opening to our show today.
Let's drink sake.
Hey, you want some?
Would you like one?
Here, maybe I should take these out.
But you can't pour your own sake, can you?
I don't think so. It's right to
Will you pour me a cup, please?
I would be honoured to pour you a cup, Dave Grohl.
Woohoo!
There you go.
I want one.
Oh, yeah. I can have one too.
Are we supposed to tell
Ooh!
You can, but it's just taking up all of your
time. Is that better?
Yes.
Very good. Welcome to the 10:30 slot. Is that true about your name, the French thing, Foo, fire, firefighter?
Kind of, firefighter?
Well, he was saying that the Foo is French slang for fire.
It is. And I think that in World War II, the Royal Air Force, the English Royal Air Force, saw weird flying balls of fire in the sky, and they would chase them, and they didn't know what they were, and they never caught them, so they called them Foo Fighters.
What are they, though?
Well, nobody knows.
Nice. And is these pictures all over your single cover and all over your set, are they flying patterns then?
Evidently they are. Yes, they are. Yes.
Okay. Well, we've worked it out and we've established that. Excellent. The song we just heard, Learn to Fly, is a taste of the new record due for release on November the 1st. There Is Nothing Left to Lose is the name of the album. Do you mind if we talked a bit about your lyrics?
Yeah, sure.
You like some sake, Dave Grohl?
Thanks.
That's okay. Do you mind if I keep using your full name?
Yes, actually, I'd rather you just call me Dave.
David. David or Dave?
David or Dave is fine.
Okay. Are you enjoying writing Foo Fighters lyrics?
Not as much as the music, but I do like to write.
Yeah. Sorry to just talk to Dave.
You neglected me on the second shot of sake there as well.
Oh, sorry, I'm very rude.
Did you do a shot?
Oh, hell yeah.
You want another one?
God.
Sure.
What's going on?
Let's get hammered and breakout
wrong kind of
real bad. I'm going to see if we can really mess up the next song.
Did you ever write with Nirvana lyrics?
No. I was just a drummer.
Just a drummer? No. Okay, but now you're the front man as well, so you get to write. And it's exciting. One line which you treed me from that song is where you say that you want a new evolution, because this one's a lie.
A new revolution.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, my question doesn't make sense then.
No.
What does it mean?
Oh, just kind of disenchanted with the general state of affairs and thinking, I'm not satisfied. I want something new.
So what, you're going to learn how to fly?
I'd love to learn how to fly.
There's a lot of people looking into the skies at the moment. They're looking at comets, they're looking for comets, they're looking for aliens,
That's
angels,
true.
Tsunamis to come and crash over their heads.
Absolutely.
Do you think the world's going to end?
No, I don't think the world will end. I think the world's been around for millions and billions and trillions of years, and how could it just end?
Well, maybe as we know it.
Well, as we know it, yeah. Mm. Talk to the dinosaurs about that.
Well, REM. And who's this guy you're looking for? I'm looking for to this guy for answers.
It's the sky.
The sky?
Yeah.
I know. Have you figured out ways to fly yourselves? You're allowed to speak.
Well, you haven't addressed me, baby.
Sorry, baby.
Did you say, baby?
Have you found ways to fly yet?
Baby. Well, since we've been in Australia, I've found several.
Look at the muscles.
Trying to relax a little.
Oh, okay. Oh, they're illegal ones.
Oh,
airplanes, blimps, OMS, I guess.
OMS?
Mm.
OMS.
They help. What am I talking about? It's been four years since your first record, the self-titled one, which was basically Dave's record, and 2 years since The Colour and The Shape, which by that stage was a much more collaborative effort with the band. How has your sound changed for this new album now that you've spent this much time together?
Oh, I think
Taylor?
That...
We're getting old. Yes, it reflects our age.
Are you old?
Oh, man, I'm 27, man.
Oh, you're not the guy from Dan Taylor.
Asked if I was 44.
Yeah, thanks. Did you say thanks a lot?
I kicked him in the crotch, man.
Yeah! Did I just break something then?
Yeah!
Yeah, okay. You went wild for a while there doing everything yourself, Dave. The first record, then the great clip for Monkey Wrench, which you directed in the elevator, very funky. The Touch soundtrack all on your own pretty much as well. Mm. How are you finding the collaborative way of working now? Are they okay to work
with? It's a lot easier than that, that's for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, it sounds better when a bunch of people go in and everyone throws their weirdness into a big pot and it comes out rather than just one weird taste. You've got lots of weird.
It's probably not as good, but it's weirder.
Yeah.
It's lots of people being weird at once. He's interesting to look at.
More weird. Mm.
You've had a couple of lineup changes since your last album.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Are they all right?
Yeah, whatever.
Kick them out.
Where did you find these?
Bring them in, kick them out. Get them on, get them off.
Is that what it's like in the band?
No, I mean...
It's like what Morrissey said, really, isn't it, Dave?
What did he say?
Remember, he goes,
Morrissey?
Morrissey from the Smiths?
Someone read this article and said, the rhythm section from the Smiths were as replaceable as any car part.
Or something like and that. He wore a Band-Aid on his nipple.
Did he?
Did he?
Apparently. Did he have a bad piercing?
Maybe. I just saw all these fans.
Was he lactating?
I don't know, Dave.
Is this a kid's show?
Yeah, no, not anymore. Yes, we've grown up. Have you signed our guest book yet?
No.
That's what this is.
Oh, I thought it was a pillow.
Well, it can be used as one to bring rock dreams to your sleeps and slumber every night. We've got a lot of famous people in here, so now we'd like, if you wouldn't mind, all four of you. Where's that one?
Nate's got mouth trouble, nerve in mouth, can't...
Is he keep going like this?
It's got toothache, basically.
Basically,
I was not going to comment, I felt rude. So here's a pen, if you would like to begin rock quoting away.
And
you
can write has to be a quote?
Well, it's got to be something rock. Don't look at the other ones. The people are saying being a musician is like, and
it just can't be like a rock quote.
Yeah.
It can be rock.
We encourage just rock quotes.
Oh, good.
What?
Nothing.
It's okay. Good, good. How's this tour been?
Oh, this isn't much of a tour. This is just doing promotional interviews and stuff. We've done a few shows here and there, but it's been pretty exhausting, actually.
Nice hotels.
We started in we've been in some pretty nice hotels.
That's all right then.
24-hour room service.
Really?
Oh my God, we have to have 24-hour room
service. Got a very large truck full of gear as well.
Well, because we need to rock.
The rockest thing about your gear was the large bin full of 30 towels.
Did you see that?
I was so impressed by that. 30 towels for two songs.
When we play, we put out so much that it takes 30 towels to lap up the sweat that we've, you know.
That's terrific. That's very rock and roll. That's about three towels each per song. Yeah,
you gotta come see
me. I always come and see you play. I love the Foo Fighters.
It's hot.
What are your next plans after Australia?
Home. And then more touring. Just shows and playing.
Just rock.
Just, that's what we live to rock.
Yes.
So, we rock to live.
That was a rock quote. Did you get that? We live to rock and we rock to live.
No, I think that's
going to
be his.
Should I write that?
Yeah.
Can I?
Okay, good. The Foo Fighters are sticking around to play another tune soon from the new record, There Is Nothing Left to Lose. Thank you very much for visiting us tonight and writing in our book, The Foo Fighters! Well, that's right!
Saturday at the Evelyn Hotel in Fitzroy, Melbourne, Victoria. That's the 16th of October. Ice cream hands.
And speaking of interesting female vocalist, The Lose, which is out very soon, we bring you the Foo Fighters with Breakout!
You make me dizzy, running circles in my head. One of these days I'll chase you down. Look who's going crazy now. No place to face my friend. Better get out. Better get out. You know you make me break out.